Good morning, storm chasing fans. I'm Doug Kiesling with stormchasingvideo.com, and I am the guy who runs all the stuff behind the scenes, and I go out chasing. So, what are you saying? Why am I out here, and why am I at the beginning of this video? Well, today is December 1st, 2020, and if you're watching this, you have survived hurricane season 2020, as it is the end of the season. Doesn't mean we're not going to get another storm. We could. The season's been crazy. It is 2020, you know, the year where everything, where COVID, the Rona, the new Ebola has been the bane of our existence. I'm wearing a bane mask just as a joke. And yeah, but before all this happened, back before there was YouTube, Facebook, social media, video sharing, you had to do videos on DVD, and you share them with your friends, and you share them with your family, and as a storm chaser, you might share a couple copies with other chasers and sell a few copies. But what we did back in 2004, we put together this video called Hurricane Charley, Punta Gorda, Florida, Friday the 13th, 2004. This is where the six of us, we kind of met up, and stars aligned, and we are able to put together this video that has never been shown officially online. I mean, there's been some pirated copies out there that got shot down, but for the end of the season, the six of us decided, let's share this on our social media platforms. So without any further ado, on this chilly Minnesota morning, on the end of the hurricane season, here is Hurricane Charley, Punta Gorda, Florida, Friday the 13th, 2004. This video is what it shows to really go through one of the most insane hurricanes that should have been upgraded to a Cat 5 in my opinion, but this storm just rapidly intensified and was just a beast when it hit. Enjoy, and don't forget to hit that like and the subscribe button. Could use your help. Thank you. With a price tag of over $20 billion and at the cost of over 24 lives, Hurricane Charley slammed into Punta Gorda, Florida on Friday the 13th of August 2004. On a scale from 1 to 5, Hurricane Charley was a 4 on the Saffir-Simpson scale. With a maximum sustained winds of 145 miles per hour, and on top of that with winds gusting to 175 miles per hour, for its size, Hurricane Charley was a monster of a storm. On the morning of Friday the 13th, our team targeted Punta Gorda, Florida for the area of maximum impact from Hurricane Charley. Our team of experienced storm chasers included some of the most experienced hurricane storm chasers in the world: Christopher Calora, Jason Foster, Jeff Gammons, Jim Edds,
Punta Gorda is a
Mark Rackley, and myself, Doug Kiesling. The main task of our chase team was to document the landfall of Hurricane Charley in a populated area while trying to do so as safely as possible. To do this, we had to find a safe shelter for our vehicles, which still allowed us access to be outside to document the storm in the safest manner possible. But we had to do this while being able to get the footage that we were looking for. In this documentary, you will ride along with us as a member of our chase team as we position ourselves directly in Hurricane Charley's path and prepare for the worst. You will see this natural disaster as it unfolds up close and personal. Hurricane Charley was a small but intense storm with an eyewall of only 5 miles in diameter at the time of landfall. However, with 145 mile per hour sustained winds and winds gusting to close to 175 miles per hour, Hurricane Charley caused tornadic-like destruction over a path up to 50 miles inland and over the city of Arcadia, Florida. So sit back and get ready to ride along with the Hurricane Chase Team as we bring you along to document, photograph, and record scientific data of this powerful storm. Hurricane Charley, which made a direct hit on Punta Gorda, Florida, was originally forecasted on August 12th to make its landfall around the Tampa and St. Petersburg, Florida area as a Category 2 hurricane. This prompted a massive evacuation from the St. Petersburg area, as well as the Tampa and surrounding Gulf Coast area of western Florida and the Barrier Islands. After chasing Hurricane Bonnie, which fell apart before even making landfall, Chris, Jason, and Jeff were getting ready to chase Charley.
This is the storm on radar, and we are right here. And you don't see that very often on the Atlantic side. This is what a major hurricane looks like. Looks like a work of art, but when that thing comes ashore, it's going to be a disaster, natural disaster.
But on the morning of Friday the 13th, with our chase team still spread far apart, spreading from Fort Myers all the way to Tampa, and Tampa still being the primary target, I decided to go and film residents of St. Petersburg trying to get in some last-minute preparations.
Hurricane Charley, go away!
The roads that connected the Tampa and St. Petersburg area were a virtual ghost town on Friday the 13th, with only law enforcement and the media on the roads, which only 18 hours ago were gridlocked with evacuations. Fortunately for the Tampa and St. Petersburg area, it was all for nothing. After everyone in our chase team finally converged in the city of Punta Gorda, there was still time for us to do one last evaluation of the target city to verify if Punta Gorda was in fact the place to be.
This is really the hard part here. There's the eye, and it looks like, okay, it did have a little northward component. Look at it. See how it's got a little bit of a north?
It does, actually, yeah.
And then Charlotte Harbor. Hell, look at that thing.
I don't know. You're right. It may...
I don't want to go too far.
Right.
Look at Doug. Doug's got his windows. Look at Doug. Doug's got his windows all kicked up, ready to rock. What up, Doug? You ready, huh?
And you know what? You got to come over to this side.
$1.45. What?
I'm even checking.
Yeah, we're talking with Scott McParland. He's up there in Queens, New York. He's telling us that Punta Gorda is a great place to be because we're on the right side. It looks like it's going to go in Charlotte Harbor, which is this area right here. We've just crossed the bridge.
We're going to knock this thing out like the fat kid in dodgeball.
Let's play ball, bro. I'm ready. We don't have much time.
I know.
That's Port Charlotte. That's Fort Myers. That's Fort Myers right there.
Right.
This thing is moving up this way. It's going to go. We don't need to move.
Let's lock and load. Let's go find a spot.
I don't think we need to move.
Just find our shelter around here.
Oops, Sergeant.
Funny bone. It's moving north-northeast, okay? We're in the spot. I mean, the maps, you know, the rain bands have covered up the map, so you can't really see the outline of the shore. But I think we're in the spot. We just find a safe place. Yeah, so you think we're going to catch that northeast corner right there.
Look at that double shield.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, this is a little bit better. I can, you know, we're...
All right, later. And with one last look around the town before the storm hit, it was time for the real work to begin. Before Punta Gorda, Florida resembled a bombed-out city in the middle of a third-world country. Now with Hurricane Charley fast approaching Punta Gorda, Florida, evacuation for us was no longer an option. After completing our final forecast, the six of us separated into two teams, with Jim and Mark heading for one part of town, and the rest of us to rendezvous at the Justice Center.
Okay, this is where we're probably going to be spending with the safest place you could be in 145 mile an hour winds, something like this. We're going to have a lot of debris flying around, but this should protect our vehicles and most likely protect us.
You want to get as close as you can to a building. The wind is coming out like this. Those are shaking over there. I don't like that.
Getting outer feeder bands, actually inner feeder bands, should be coming pretty much from that direction. It's going to get very, very loud, and it's going to get very, very bad here.
And so they're going to come from this direction. We'll just have to walk back and monitor the whole stuff. In the eye, we'll have to reposition the cars. That's what we'll do, because the eye's going to come over.
All right, let's go.
While Jim was still looking for safe parking options, I was still scouting out the town when the storm was starting to come on shore, and I needed to find the team fast.
Hey, Jeff, can you hear me yet? Okay, yeah, I'm at the Justice Center. Okay, I see you guys. Sweet.
We're in the northern fringe of the outer eye wall. This is a double eye wall system. We'll actually get a strong wind through here. It should let up a little bit. That would be the space between the outer and inner eye wall. The inner eye wall come aboard, gust to 175, maybe more. Sustained 145, that's when most of the damage
this
will occur.
This is going to be an intense storm.
So we're waiting and hoping, and let God be with us all.
As you can see, we have data. We have the eye, the hurricane approaching us on radar. This laptop, we have our radar going. This laptop is recording data on the weather instruments, barometer, wind pressure, stuff like that. So.
This is a civil emergency message. DeSoto County Emergency Management has issued a mandatory evacuation of all mobile homes in DeSoto County. Hurricane Charley has become a very powerful Category 4 storm. A mandatory evacuation of all mobile homes in DeSoto County has been ordered.
We're about ready to go into something big and dangerous.
The clock in the Clock Tower Plaza was shortly before 3 p.m. as Hurricane Charley raced towards Punta Gorda. We all started to get our last images of Punta Gorda before it was changed forever by Hurricane Charley as the heavier rains moved in. And before we knew it, the warnings from the National Weather Service were already being issued.
The National Weather Service in Ruskin has issued a tornado warning for eastern Manatee County and northeastern Sarasota County in Florida until 4 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time.
Jim and Mark are well known for their underwater cinematography, so the first thing they did was head for the harbor to do some storm surge video.
45 minutes. This is the fastest hurricane I've ever had. This is it.
Eye wall, outer eye wall coming in, outer eye wall coming in.
Hurricane Charley making landfall right here. Fort Myers, Sanibel, Punta Gorda, it's right where we're at. You can see we're all set, recording data. And then you come out here, and you have Hurricane Charley's eye wall just about ready to come on shore.
With the storm starting to move in, Jason still found some time to have some fun playing in the wind, while the rest of us started documenting what we could before the storm destroyed the town. We were surprised to find some people were still trying to evacuate at the last minute, even as the debris started to fly through the air and the trees started falling.
The National Weather Service in Ruskin has issued a tornado warning for northeastern Hardy County and northwestern Highlands County in Florida until 4:15 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. At 3:41 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, National Weather Service Doppler radar indicated a tornado 7 miles south of Sebring, moving northwest at 45 miles an hour. The tornado will affect Sebring by 3:40 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time.
50.
150?
150.
So this is a super hurricane, 150. Not a Cat 5, but very close. Strong Category 4, 150 sustained.
With debris now blowing around, we started to hear a strange sound in the distance.
Setting all the car alarms off.
I was finally able to get over to the harbor myself to film some waves and storm surge, and I was amazed at the power of the wind.
Here comes the eye wall. Eye wall coming in. There's the eye wall. Eye wall's right up the street. It's the eye wall coming in. Yeah, I know. Feel it. Feel pressure in your ears. Here comes the tagging rain. See outer eye wall coming aboard.
But unfortunately, I didn't tell anybody where I was going, and the rest of the team started to wonder where I was.
I hear a lot of crashing and banging. I hope he's all right.
The National Weather Service in Ruskin has issued a special marine warning for the coastal waters from Charlotte Harbor between Charlotte and Lee counties until 4:30 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. Time is 4:09 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. This is a civil emergency message.
We all soon found a brand new unexpected hazard to hurricane chasing. Flying political yard signs.
Charlotte Harbor.
Sardine, we're
yep.
here.
We're here, man.
August 13th, Friday, August 13th, 2004. Hurricane Charley's eye wall just entering the outer edges of it.
Now with the larger pieces of debris flying through the air and the winds now blowing at hurricane force, the chance for us to stop and evacuate from Charley's path was no longer an option. We were in for the duration of the storm.
National Weather Service in Ruskin issued at 3:52 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, Friday, August 13th.
All right, it's Friday the 13th. And we're chasing Hurricane Charley. Some roof just flew off over here. We'll try and see if I'm brave enough to go out and see what the hell happened.
And now the real work and the real danger begins. Now with the wind blowing the rain at hurricane force at us, it's at this time that I'm really enjoying the fact that I have an underwater housing for my camera. Thankfully, with the underwater housings and waterproofing that we've done to our camera gear, we were able to get a lot more creative shots with this storm than we have in the past.
What? Trees!
But unfortunately, my cell phone keeps ringing and the TV networks keep calling to find out where I am and what I'm seeing.
This dog, it better be good. I'm in the middle of a hurricane. And right now we're shooting tons of B-roll. We're non-stop, several cameras. But call me back in 3 hours. We can totally set something up. But I don't want to have my phone out in the water. We got debris flying around, trees coming down.
As the wind suddenly picked up, the fun and games of the storm soon ended fast. We found out after the storm that Jim Ads was just 2 blocks away from us at the Bank of America building, sitting outside recording some incredible footage. But I continued to venture down the street to see what I could find.
I don't know if this is coming out on video, but this thing sounds like a freight train. It sounds just like a train.
And you really do have to watch out for those political yard signs when the wind starts blowing.
We got the yaw wall moving in. Wind's gusting probably over 120, 130 miles an hour now. Listen to the roar.
As I venture a couple blocks away, all Jeff and Chris could see was my orange rain suit in a field of flying debris. Now the debris gets bigger and bigger as I try to get a different perspective on the storm.
Building's coming apart here. Whoa! We're in danger.
Time is 4:14 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. This is NOAA Weather Radio WWG-59, serving a portion of South Central Florida.
With being exposed to all the debris starting to fly at me from every direction, it was no longer safe to stay where I was.
Tornado warning for northeastern Hardy and northwestern Highlands counties has been allowed to expire. At 4:15 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, National Weather Service radar indicated the tornado had weakened and was no longer a threat. Thus, the warning has been allowed to expire.
Now, while I try to make it back to the safety of the Justice Center, Jim gets ready to ride out the storm in the center of a debris field.
Unbelievable!
Yeehaw! We're having fun now, baby!
Debris flying everywhere. Got branches and whole trees being wafted by this.
Pressure's at 905 millibars, by the way. Hold it fast.
Are we almost in the eye?
Not yet.
Hurricane Charley has become a very powerful Category 4 storm. A mandatory evacuation of all mobile homes in DeSoto County has been ordered. Residents are instructed to go to the Turner Civic Center located at 2250 Northeast Roan Street. Again, residents are instructed to go to the Turner Civic Center located at 2250 Northeast Roan Street. Repeating, mandatory evacuation for all mobile homes in DeSoto County.
The short-term forecast from the National Weather Service issued at 4:10 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time Friday, August 13th. From Bonita Beach to Englewood out to 20 nautical miles. Charlotte, Citrus, DeSoto, Englewood to Tarpon Springs out to 20 nautical miles. Hardy, Hernando, Highlands, Hillsboro, Lee, Levy, Manatee, Pasco, Pinellas, Pogue, Sarasota, Sumter, Tampa.
Now, with the wind starting to pick up rapidly, Chris and Jason still had time to play in the slipstream of the wind going around the building. Before I dared to cross the street back to the courthouse, I had to wait for a calm between the rain bands, and it didn't look like that was happening anytime soon.
Time is 4:21 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time.
I still had to cross the street, which is now a river of flying deadly debris.
That almost knocked him out of his feet.
As Chris, Jason, and Jeff watched one of the roofs in town fly off, Mark was lucky to avoid almost getting hit by the roof itself. You could see the power of Hurricane Charley just by looking at the clouds and how fast it went by us.
One of the windows must have blown out or something.
Yeah, the roof's starting to come apart too.
Whose towel is that?
This has got to be the inner eye wall. Yeah, see the pieces of roof are coming off. Yeah, look at all the debris. The trees are starting to come apart. Yeah.
See how Doug's doing, alright?
I've never seen ocean like that. Look at that!
I know. It's insane.
Alright, good. I was just about to go over and see how you're...
Stop!
We had a good, I went out and stood in it for a little while. I literally moved 7 feet vertically.
Is it like a blizzard?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Just got freezing your ass off.
The time was now about 4:30 in the afternoon, and the worst of Hurricane Charley was about to hit us. Over the next 15 minutes, we were not sure what to expect, except to expect the worst.
All right, we got more roof action over here. There's a minivan. You see the minivan? Just pull up right over here. It's like, dude, what are you doing out here?
Here we are, folks!
Yeah, it is. It is getting warmer. Not now. I'm freezing, not that crazy.
It's just like being in a movie, isn't it?
Oh, this
real
is
a freaking thing.
This is extreme. This is about as extreme as you get. Yeah, something in the building must have got destroyed. I see papers flying everywhere. Whoa. We got debris, lots of debris.
Now, with the clock in the clock tower plaza frozen in time at 3:34 p.m., the storm seemed to pass us by as if going in slow motion as the eye wall slammed into Punta Gorda. But little did we know, just 2 blocks away from us at the Bank of America building, Jim Edge was hanging on for his life.
This town is coming apart!
Palm trees are starting to come down. I see a couple palms over there in the end just came down.
All we could do now is just hang on for the ride of our lives.
There's debris flying everywhere. I've taken shelter in the car. There's projectiles everywhere. Oh, there goes your towel.
Oh my God, look at that. Like, go!
Thank you.
You better be careful.
With the worst of Hurricane Charley now on top of us, all we could do was hang on until the storm was over, as Hurricane Charley ravaged the city of Punta Gorda, Florida.
What is this?
Sheet metal tying up on the thing over there. I don't see Jeff. As we investigate the sheet metal that slammed into the back of my Jeep, the power of the wind sucks Chris along the other side of my Jeep and back out to the front.
Leave it there! Leave it!
Take care of us.
Now we were in the inner eye wall of Hurricane Charley, with winds gusting to over 175 miles per hour and sustained winds of 150 miles per hour. All we could do was wait for the calm of the eye to catch our breaths.
Wow! Holy shit! Jason and Chris look up and notice that the clouds are still. We are now entering the eye of Hurricane Charley. As the eye of Hurricane Charley passed over us, the calm did not last long. We barely had time to regroup before the second half of Hurricane Charley came to town.
Look, do you see the sheet metal just the other side?
Oh.
A big old piece of sheet metal came flying right by us. We were pinned up against the water, and if you saw us, you couldn't move.
Chris, we're in the eye.
Yeah.
There's the...
It might be sideswiping us.
Yeah, it is.
It's starting to start up again.
It's 943 millibars. Could you believe that? I'm going to pull up a little bit. I'm pulling up a little bit.
Okay.
Oh,
turn
man.
Turn me apart.
Man.
Get out of there!
Not much of a calm in this eye.
Get close to the pressure center, would you? Go through it.
It was not long before we got hit by the second half of Hurricane Charley, so we took a quick look around and documented what we could.
Wind shifted 180 degrees.
But before Chris knew it, the second half of Hurricane Charley was on top of Punta Gorda, and he was trapped out in the courtyard and had to take shelter in the hallway between the buildings of the Justice Center.
Woo!
Now, like a cruel joke, what was damaged by Hurricane Charley's winds coming from one direction were now being destroyed as the wind shifted 180 degrees to come in from the other direction.
Just got knocked down by the wind going through the tunnel there. Wow. Got the second half of this thing.
Well, I hope I get through this.
With the western side of Hurricane Charley's eyewall now on top of us, and the compactness of the hurricane eyewall itself, the southwest side of Hurricane Charley was just as dangerous as the northeast or right front quadrant of Hurricane Charley's eye.
Copy me okay?
Yeah, what's up?
All right, I'm just waiting for the windows to blow out here. Is that corner up where you are? Is it pretty safe? I mean, so you get wind?
I don't know. I'm shaking up here with the car's shaking really bad.
I think my truck's coming apart too. I can hear all kinds of flying off of it.
Wow! This is unbelievable!
See if I can get a wind measurement with the Davis.
As Jason was trying to take wind measurements from his truck in the tunnel, at the front of the tunnel, the wind was trying to tear my truck apart.
Just got 63 miles per hour and I barely stuck it out the window.
I can always tell when there's going to be a big wind surge because the pressure drops and my ears pop. It's pretty scary feeling. All you hear is glass breaking, stuff breaking out there.
Have to wait here a little bit. It's the second half of the storm coming by. Can't stay in here. Got debris. Winds here are probably about 130 blowing through this power door.
ears keep popping.
Well, my ears pop twice.
We should be getting past the worst of this.
I know.
Got the hiccups.
We're gonna have a real hard time getting out of here too, because there's tons of debris now.
Hopefully it's
Chris.
Yeah, I'm worried about Chris too, because last time I saw him, he was standing out around the corner and I saw a big debris field coming at him, and then I didn't see him again, so I don't know where he's at.
A lot of debris flying through here. I gotta stay as close as possible against the wall. Stay in the boundary layer. God. My God. Come on, baby. And.
Where's Doug?
He's in his truck.
Oh, he finally got in his truck?
Yeah. Chris might be in the truck with him. I'm thinking about it. I'm not 100% sure. God help this place. God help everybody. It looked like the second half of the eye wall coming through. Wind shifted northwest, that's what it was. I'm trying to stay up against the wall here. We got debris and all kinds of water, everything flying through this corridor here. The eye passed over briefly. Pressure in the center measured 943 millibars. Very low. Pressure should start going back up now. Wind's out of the northwest opposed to southeast. Smallest eye I've ever seen, probably about less than 8 miles wide.
Our Sprint cards were still connected to the internet. We were still able to get data and chat online, even while we were getting slammed with 150 mile an hour winds.
Well, we're worried about Chris. Chris took off toward the tunnel.
What tunnel?
The tunnel that goes toward the backside of the building, right when one of those blasts comes from debris. We haven't seen him, so he's either, I hope he's pinned.
He'll be fine.
I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to wait here a little bit. Thank you.
scariest thing I ever did in my life. I didn't have my car shifted. The wind shifted in my car. I guess something came off the roof of this big bank here, Bank of America. And knocked the window out. So I'm laid up right now. I don't recommend anybody do this. You get this spot, the wind shift on you, and it's not safe anymore. And ain't too many safe places around here, I can tell you that. The only way I can do this interview is the winds have let off just a tad. That eye wall hit, it was holy smokes. Am I gonna get out of here alive? Came back to the car, Mark said, leave it, get out of here, you're gonna get killed. So we had to go around the corner. I don't know where Mark is right now.
Doug's doing down there.
Now it's working.
A piece of it fly off. Something big and red came off your truck.
So awesome.
Fire alarms going off in this building. Flashing.
I think all this papers, I think the
windows are blown out.
And all.
The storm finally letting up, we were starting to feel safe again. But we could not let our guard down, because Charley still had a few more punches left to hand out. As the storm now rapidly moved off to the northeast, we started to get our first look around Punta Gorda. It did not take long for us to realize that this town was now destroyed. As the storm ended and we left the safety of our sheltered area at the Justice Center, we soon learned of the severity of Charley's wrath as the debris was everywhere. The first thing we did was to look for Jim and Mark, but just avoiding all the debris in the road was difficult. Fortunately, as soon as I got up to the corner, I saw Jim just down the street. And we were happy to find him in one piece. But his car, that was a different story.
Oh, there's Jim Ed's. Pull up.
Yeah.
Jim lost his window. Oh my God!
Something was on the other side of that bank. Mark, he didn't get hit, I got nailed. Something fell through the top here.
Oh, I almost died, man.
Oh no.
It'll run.
Jim Ed's is... Hurricane Chaser, his car took a beating, but he's alive.
Well, yeah, hey, I am lucky to be alive because I got in a little alleyway there and the wind started clocking around and things started blowing by me. I'm going, this is great video, man. They're going to love to see this. This thing's falling right in front of me. I'm like, this ain't too cool. This is right in front of me.
Now that we found Jim, now we had to look for Mark to make sure he was still alive and all right. Then we could worry about documenting the aftermath of Hurricane Charley. As we drove back past the Clock Tower Plaza, the time was only 6 p.m. It's been only 2.5 hours since Hurricane Charley first hit the town. With many of the roads blocked by downed trees and debris, the damage that we found on some of the buildings was unbelievable. Fortunately, we soon found Mark, and it was only then that we could start to share our stories with each other about what we just went through.
Look at these dogs.
It's your body outline on the
I was hanging
there.
On the edge, man. On the line.
Little, I was like, were you rolling tape when you were down there?
Yeah, bro.
Yeah, he was.
I was rolling mad footy, bro.
He's going down there. Our father who earned him.
Yeah, I was started running out like 5 minutes.
You know, the guy
I go, this thing's probably kicking up. I go, I could get dragged off, but I better start thinking about tape. I got 5 minutes left.
That's all you had left when you're
5 minutes left, and it
started. The guy's in the shore, you know, in the inner eye wall, and then you have the main eye wall. That's why there was a little lull. It was really hard, then a little lull, and then bam!
It was ripping.
Chris's car was going.
Oh, my Jeep was doing that too.
Free hit me.
Please, God, get me through this and I'll never chase another hurricane.
Well, you know what? I knew we'd all be coming out just fine because we're all together in this one.
That was a Cat 4 under the belt.
That's right. That's my first.
And Danielle is off Africa right now.
Look at him in the leg, man. Disaster area.
Ground zero.
Ground zero, bro. Your crib took a little bit of punishment, huh?
Well, yeah, we got pretty much devastated, but we'll recover. Somehow, I don't know how. We're gonna recover.
You'll be fine.
It's a mess.
I can't believe what we just went through, bro.
Huh?
I can't believe what we just went through, bro.
I can't either.
I'm from Ireland. You're from Ireland? You ain't even seen no hurricanes like that, huh?
And I've been here 22 years. I've been here 22 years. And I've always wanted to ride through a hurricane, and today I did. So I did something today.
These dogs have been hit by a riot.
Mother Nature's decided to redecorate our town.
It just ripped the stucco right off the building.
There we go. Y'all dogs come out here. You know you could have died. You know that, right?
I thought we were going to die.
Huh?
I thought we were really close to dying.
Yeah, the thought was starting.
The pressure dropped so fast. The wind went up. It was intense.
You could die.
Die.
Dead. I was like, I'm looking and I'm going. At any split second, something's going to and you're going to be gone. You're dragged off.
And what happens is, you know, it's like when we were sitting there, and I remember us thinking, it's like as soon as you start losing, when you start getting that whiteout condition, that's when you really start getting scary because, God, you can't see anything, so you don't even know what's coming at you.
Whiteout, bro.
Yeah.
Looks like a war zone hit, bro.
The courthouse is blown out.
All right, let me down off this sloppy mess, man. Y'all trying to kill me. You got bricks everywhere.
What?
Huh?
It's a disaster.
Disaster zone.
What the hell?
God, destroyed. It's all sucked up like this, too.
After taking a short break and talking with some of the local residents who also rode out Hurricane Charley, we started to document the immediate aftermath of Hurricane Charley. The constant sound of building alarms running out of backup batteries was quite eerie.
Got to dry the camera off. Got a little wet. Mm-hmm. At least it wasn't salt water.
Yeah, salt water would kill it.
Yep.
Been killing plenty.
Now the first responders and emergency services started to pour into Punta Gorda from all across Florida. But so did somebody else, such as this man looting the remains of the body shop for a gas can.
The looter right there.
Hey, buddy. Hey, how you doing?
And with parts of the town reduced to rubble, it was hard to tell which buildings were empty before the storm and which buildings had everything blown out of them. As we started to see more of the residents of Punta Gorda come out to review the damage, we started to wonder how many of them actually stayed behind and rode out the storm with us. With the massive structural failure to a lot of the buildings in Punta Gorda, we thought that there would be a lot more casualties due to the storm. One of the best examples of the power of the Category 4 Hurricane Charley was the Best Western sign, which was torn off and its I-beam supports twisted like taffy. As more people came out and started to drive around in the damage, some of them got hung up on down power lines and started dragging debris with them.
I would have died here for sure.
Okay, stop.
With Punta Gorda now a disaster area and emergency relief pouring in from across the region, all we could do is document the after effects and get out of the way. In just 3 hours, the before and after of Hurricane Charley was still surreal to us as we drove down Olympia. But as the sun started to set on this Friday the 13th, we took one last look around Punta Gorda. Among the road hazards due to all the debris, we still had to watch out for other storm chasers cutting across four lanes of traffic to make a U-turn.
All the trees have been decapitated.
And as Jason's luck would have it,
debris nail.
Yeah,
look at that.
That's what it is. Get a close up of that.
He was the only one to have a tire damaged by the debris.
You bro got a hole in the tire because there's roots flying off. Storm chasing, you know, you get. Shit in your tires, man. I mean, it's just how it is, you know?
One of the worst places to be in the middle of a hurricane is anywhere near a gas station. Their canopies are usually the first thing to go down and be destroyed, and then you have to deal with leaking fuel.
Oh, wow. There's gas leaking.
Some of the damaged areas looked a lot worse than others, which led us to think there may have been some embedded tornadoes. Now it was time to leave the area, but not without one last look at what the power of the wind can do.
That is pure wind. That is pure wind damage.
Of all mobile homes. Hurricane Charley has become a very powerful Category 4 storm.